Hi, everyone. Welcome back. Today, I'm doing a long-awaited and much-promised tutorial on a Resolve to Adobe Premiere proxy workflow. So what we'll be doing today is we'll be prepping raw camera files in Resolve. We'll manage the metadata there. We'll export proxies. And then we'll bring everything into Adobe Premiere with all the relevant metadata that we need. And we'll sync the audio in Premiere. If you've watched my previous tutorial on Resolve to Avid workflows, a lot of the early stuff in this one is very similar, so feel free to check out the description box below for chapter markers and jump to the sections that you need. Also, if you find this useful, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel, and do let me know in the comments what other videos you might like to see. Okay, let's get into it. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a new project in DaVinci Resolve. Now, I'm using the studio version of Resolve, but you can use the free version of Resolve for this. It'll work exactly the same way. So I'm just going to create a new project, and I'm going to call it dailies. I tend to use a three-letter short form for a lot of my projects, and then I'll call this underscore dailies. Okay, so now here we are in Resolve. Across the bottom, you might know we have the media page, the cut page, the edit page. We have fusion and color and fairlight, and then we have the deliver page at the end. So we're only going to be using some of these sections for our dailies workflow today. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do here in Resolve before I bring any clips into the project is I want to have a look at my project settings and set it up the way that I think I'm going to need it for dailies. So in this case, the main things that I'm going to be looking at are this stuff right at the top in the master settings. We've got the timeline resolution and we've got the frame rate. So in my case, I know that I want to be creating dailies in HD. So even though my raw footage is at a higher resolution, I think it's like at least 3 or 4K, it could even be higher, I'm going to be creating HD timelines because that's the resolution of the proxies that I'm going to be making for Premiere. So I'm going to leave that set to 1920 by 1080 HD. I'm also going to set my timeline frame rate to 23976 because I know that that is the frame rate that I'm going to be working in editorially with my proxies in Premiere. So ideally, you want to set all of this up in preparation for whatever you're going to be doing in your offline edit project. And everything else we can leave for now. I'm going to go back and show you some other settings as we go along, but that's the main thing that you want to look at before you start. So then you're going to click save. And as we can see, there are no clips currently in the media pool, but now I'm going to go through the process of importing the clips that I want from my camera drive. So you can do that in a couple of different ways. Obviously, you can navigate up here into your different media storage devices, and you can find the files that you need. Another option is to just open a Finder window or Windows Explorer window and drag the clips right in here. Okay, so I've currently brought in two camera cards into my media pool. Obviously, if you have a full day or several days of shooting, you would bring everything in at once, probably into different bins here. But I'm just going to do these two as an example as we go through this process. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do as I'm looking through is I'm going to do an assessment of the footage. So basically, that means I'm just going to kind of click on this stuff, look and see like what the frame rate is under the FPS column. I'm going to look at the format. I'm going to look at the resolution, and I'm just going to make sure that this is kind of what I was expecting. If you find that it comes in at like a weird low resolution or a weird frame rate, then you can identify that maybe you've accidentally linked to some camera created proxies instead of the original raw footage. So this is just like an initial assessment. Just make sure that everything is what you expect. I'm also looking at the audio channels here. In this case, I have no audio channels because I know they record a double system, and I'm going to be doing the audio syncing in Premiere later. If you have a project where they recorded audio in the camera, then you will probably see audio channels, and then you should also hear audio when it's played back. So just have a quick look and make sure everything looks the way that you expect. So the next step I'm going to do is probably like the 100% most important step in doing these dailies, and that is putting something in the real name column for all of these clips. As you can see right now, as the files have come in, the real name column is empty. And this column is really, really crucial when you get to the end of the project and you're going to be relinking your low-res footage back to your camera originals for color correction and finishing. If you don't have a real name, it can cause a whole bunch of problems. So we're going to get Resolve to help us by assigning real names. So we can go into the settings, Resolve project settings here. And in the general options area, we have this lovely little assist using real names from the checkbox. So we're going to turn that on. It's turned off by default. And then what it's telling us is that Resolve is going to help by like creating real names automatically based on whatever criteria that we want. So there's a few different options here. My favorite is source clip file name. That is usually the best option because it's almost guaranteed to be unique. As you can see, when I save that, the real name is now populated and Resolve has basically taken the file name, removed the file extension, and made that into the real name. So we have a whole bunch of unique real names here. And provided that all of your clip names across your project are unique, and they usually are if you're working with a higher end camera, then this can be a really great method. It doesn't work very well if you're using lower end cameras, DSLR cameras, or drones that can sometimes repeat file names. So if your drone operator has reset their camera, or if you're using multiple drone operators that are using the same file structure, then that can get really messy. So what you can do here is, and I'll show this example because this is like some test footage that I'm not even going to export, but what you can do is, rather than using the system-wide, project-wide setting, you can actually select a bunch of clips individually, right-click, and you can go to Clip Attributes, and then under Name, you can create a custom real name. So you can actually create like a user-defined real name. So you can call it like Test Camera 01 or like Drone 02 or whatever you want to call it, and click OK. And that way, you can be confident that you're not going to be having repeated real names across different cameras or different days. So once you've added real names, there are a few other pieces of metadata that you can choose to add if you want. Now, Resolve has like this really robust metadata window, which you can see they have like so many different options for fields for your metadata. Unfortunately, most of these fields don't actually translate out of Resolve and into other software programs. Only a small number of them do. So it's not super practical to put a ton of data into these fields, but I can tell you the fields that work that will cross over in our metadata transfer. The description field, you can put something in there. The comments field, you can put something in there. The good take field works. That shows up as the good shot checkbox in Premiere. So those are the ones that I kind of tend to use in Resolve if I want to. And then everything else, I would probably add the rest of the important column data in Premiere. So if I wanted to add production day, shoot dates, other notes, log notes, that sort of thing, I would use Premiere's metadata rather than doing it in Resolve. So for the purposes of this, let's just say we're going to select a bunch of clips and we're going to put a description and we're just going to say shot on day one, for example. And then we're going to actually put the LUT information in the comments field, which we'll be doing a LUT in a second, and I'll show you that. And then let's just like for fun, let's say, oops. We're going to say that like three of these are good takes, and I'm just going to kind of select them randomly, just so that we can see how the metadata comes through. And we're going to click save. So you can change the metadata on these clips as a group by selecting a bunch, or you can just do them one at a time. This tutorial is continued in the next video. If you have questions, you can pop them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer. By the way, if you like this content, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel and let me know in the comments what other content you might like to see. Thanks for watching.